Now, it needs to realise dishes don't wash themselves, you know?
The plates don't put themselves away either, do we, plates? No, we don't.
I just came to see if you calmed down after yesterday. It was Carter's idea and he just wanted to help.
How is humiliating me gonna help, eh? And as for my supposed best friend getting involved, I'm speechless.
Had I known, I would have run it by you, okay? I'm sorry.
Hey, these two are more like an old married couple than friends.
Look, this isn't Tony's fault, it's mine. If I didn't have this stupid anxiety thing, then...
It's not stupid.
Well, if I didn't have it, I would have been able to resit my exams and I probably would even have a job by now. And I wouldn't have had to talk to Mr. Shepherd.
Why? What did he say to Mr. Shepherd?
I asked him to reinstate Nancy's sick leave pay.
Right, and what did he say?
It's out of his control. And then he came up with a fundraiser thing. Anyway, go and tell him to call it off.
Wait, Charlie, just wait, look. It's me, I just find it uncomfortable people knowing that I'm struggling.
Come on, Darren. We all struggle. And you know more than anyone how important it is not to bottle things up, to ask for help when you need it. People in this village, they're not just your neighbours, they're your friends. They know you've had a tough time lately and they just want to help. Just let them do it for you, yeah?
Yeah.
Just try and stay calm.
Hey, it's a good turnout.
Darren? What is it?
Never thought I'd find myself in this position.
Look, son, when you get to my age, you realise that life doesn't always turn out the way you expect it to.
Hey, I just wanted to say thank you for everything you're doing.
Hey, look, if I've learnt one thing in life, it's never to withhold good from people who need it.
That's a good ethos to live by.
And the world will be a better place if we help those in need. Anyway, look, I need to get back to the school, but if you need anything, I'm your man.
Thank you.
You know, he's a good man. I wish everyone in the village could be like him.
Just wish it wasn't me who's been charitable to.
Hey, come on, you'll get through this.
You reckon?
Yeah, of course you will. Look at the ups and downs I've had over the last few years. He's got wrong with the punches.
Yeah, I know. I just wish life had stopped dishing out the jobs to my family 24/7, that's all.
I'm so mad I was one away from guessing the sweets in that jar.
Well, why don't we go to Price Slice later and I'll get you any chocolate bar that you want.
Okay.
Hey, how did my cupcakes go down?
Yeah, not great.
Yeah, hardly anyone bought them, and those that did thought they tasted rank.
What?
Kidding!
Yeah, there's barely any left.
Oh, I knew it. No one does whip frosting like me.
Yeah, mate.
Oh, there you are. I've got something for you.
Oh, no, what now?
Keys to your new abode. Well, for a little bit, anyway.
What?
Well, you said you could do with a breather. So I've arranged for you two, plus Oscar and Phoenix, to have one. In a little cottage in Wales.
Oh, nice.
That means I get the run of the place when you're gone.
Tony.
Hey, come on. What did Carter say about helping out people when we can?
You're not exactly minted, are you?
Let's just say a fellow councilman owed me a favour. It's his cottage. Now, I know that October's not the best month to be going away in this country, but, you know, I thought you could do with a break.
Oh, we really appreciate this, thank you.
Whereabouts in Wales, is it?
Well, have to give me a second to get through this. San Fire Posquini, Scogere, we Metropolis, San Desilio, go, go, go.
I dare you say that again.
Hey.
But look. I know you and me aren't, you know, touchy-feely kind of guys.
Yeah, apart from the naps.
Oh, come here, you.
Hey, this guy, eh? Look at him. Look at him.